Good morning, dear students. So we were studying the chapter respiration in plants. Okay, I hope you all have gone through my previous lecture video and you have no problem. So moving forward, we have already learnt about what is respiration, how are we going to take the glucose molecule, how it is been converted into pyruvate, and glycolysis and Krebs cycle. We have already discussed about that. Also, we have discussed about the respiration, difference between respiration and burning. So now we will be going on to the next part, that is the two kind of respiration. One is aerobic respiration, another one is anaerobic respiration. Okay, so these are the types. What are the types? One is aerobic, another one is anaerobic. Now already I have discussed about aerobic and anaerobic discussion in my previous lecture, right? So what is aerobic respiration and what is anaerobic respiration? Aerobic respiration stands for the respiration where the breaking up of the glucose molecule will be there in presence of oxygen, okay? And anaerobic respiration is the breaking up of the glucose molecule in absence of oxygen. So this qualifies aerobic respiration and anaerobic respiration. Now we'll be learning a bit detailed about both of these. So the first thing is the equation. Or what are the equation that we use for aerobic respiration that I have already mentioned, yet I am writing it once again. It is C6H12O6 plus 6O2. Now it gives out 6CO2 plus 6H2O plus 38 ATP of energy. Okay, so this is the equation for aerobic respiration. Now students, please follow your book, that is Concise Biology Part 1 Class 9. We are following that one. Please open page number 57. You will be finding things over there. Okay, now two kind of respiration. One is aerobic respiration, another one is anaerobic respiration. What happened in aerobic respiration? Normally free oxygen is used in respiration and there is complete oxidation of glucose with the formation of carbon dioxide and water as end result. So end product is carbon dioxide and water and 38 ATP of energy that we have already learned in our previous video lecture. Also, one more thing, it is very important that it occurs with the help of particular enzyme. Okay. So enzymes convert this to this. Am I clear? Now moving forward, we have respiration proceed only when oxygen, a constituent of air, is available and is therefore called aerobic respiration. It is also known as oxybolic respiration or oxybiotic respiration. Okay. This is also known as oxybiotic respiration, okay, or aerobic respiration. Now we will be studying about anaerobic respiration. What happens in anaerobic respiration? See, anaerobic respiration is the breaking down of the glucose molecule without oxygen or in absence of oxygen. Now what happened, what the equation it happens? It happens like this: C6H12O6. Okay, now this is a glucose molecule. It gets break down to one compound which is known as ethanol. Okay, it is known as ethanol. It is C2H5OH. This is known as ethanol, plus another product that we get is CO2. And here, my dear student, here the energy is only 2 ATP. The energy is only 2 ATP of energy. Okay, so we can see that aerobic respiration in presence of oxygen, we get an ATP energy is of 38, and without the presence of oxygen we get only 2 ATP of energy. Thus we can easily conclude from these two equations that in aerobic respiration we get much amount of energy, and in anaerobic respiration we get only a few amount of energy. Okay, now one more thing, this is known as ethanol. Okay, now if we balance this particular equation, we will be getting here 1, 2 and here 1, 2. Okay, now anyway, let's follow your book. Sometimes certain parts of plant including fruits and seeds may temporarily respire even in the absence of oxygen. In this type of respiration, the glucose molecule is incompletely broken down into ethanol or ethyl alcohol and carbon dioxide with the release of small quantity of energy. Okay, this chemical reaction can be represented in the following manner. So this is the chemical reaction for anaerobic respiration. Okay, moving forward, we'll be have this type of respiration is called anaerobic or anoxybiotic reaction. Anoxybiotic, that one is oxybiotic, this one is anoxybiotic reaction. Respiration as it proceeds even without oxygen. Anaerobic respiration in any part of the plant cannot continue for more than few days, and that part ultimately dies. But there are certain microscopic organisms such as certain bacteria and fungi which normally respire only anaerobically. Okay. So even the germinating seed, when deprived of air, respire anaerobically, and that is described in experiment number 5 of figure 7.7. We will be coming to that later on. Anyway, first quickly come to the differences between aerobic respiration and anaerobic respiration. What we will be getting over there? Process, proceed in the presence of oxygen, definitely aerobic, and anaerobic is without the in the absence of oxygen. Complete breakdown of glucose, it is incomplete breakdown of glucose. End products are carbon dioxide and water, and there the end product is alcohol and carbon dioxide. Ethyl alcohol, this product is known as ethyl alcohol. Okay, this product is known as ethyl alcohol. And this is carbon dioxide, as we all know. This is glucose. This is glucose, ethyl alcohol, and it produces 2 ATP, and here we get 38 ATP of energy. Okay, now moving forward, we will be having the differences that we are talking about. Energy liberated in large quantities, that is 38 ATP from 1 mole of glucose, and here energy liberated is in small quantities, that is 2 ATP from 1 mole of glucose. It occurs normally throughout the life. That is, aerobic respiration occurs throughout the life. Anaerobical respiration occurs temporarily for a shorter period when the oxygen constituents in our body or the oxygen constituent in our body is very less. Okay. So now we have certain experiments. These experiments are important for your exam. Questions are going to come. Even some of the diagrams are going to come. Okay. So we will be going through this experiment one by one. I am requesting you all to open your book page number 57 so that we can you can actually follow this particular experiments. Okay, now experiments to prove that oxygen is used up in respiration. Now while going for the experiments, okay, I am rubbing this portion. I hope you all have copied that in your biology copy, and if not, you can rewind it and play this video as much time as you can. Also you can share it with your friends. So going on, we have the experiment. In experiment, please keep in your mind, my dear student, we have always two things. What? One is known as experimental setup. Another is known as control setup. Now, what is this experimental setup and control setup? Control setup is that particular parameter with which we are going to make a contrast of what happened in this experimental setup. In experimental setup, we will be doing the experiment, and in control setup, we will be keeping it sometimes blank, or we will be keeping it to prove that some change have occurred within this experimental setup with respect to the control setup. Okay, so here experiment to prove that oxygen is used up in respiration. So we'll be proving that oxygen is used up during respiration. How can we do that? First, we'll be taking two flasks. Okay, now in flask A, we'll be keeping germinating bean seeds. Okay, and in flask B, we'll be keeping dead bean seeds. Now see, flask B is control for here, and flask A is the experimental setup over here. Okay, now what we'll be doing is we'll be keeping soda lime solution in both the test tubes. Okay, an apparatus is arranged as shown in figure 7.2. Flask A contains germinating bean seed and flask B has dead or boiled seed together with some antiseptic such as carbolic acid to avoid bacterial decay. Now why we will be adding carbolic acid? Just to avoid the bacterial decay in the flask B. Okay, now moving forward, we'll be having wet cotton provides water to both the samples. A small tube containing soda lime, a mixture of sodium hydroxide and calcium oxide, is suspended in each of the flasks for absorbing any carbon dioxide. So the function of soda lime is to absorb carbon dioxide, as we'll be proving, right, that oxygen is required, not carbon dioxide. So we'll be just removing the carbon dioxide from the setups. Now what we will see is that after a few days, the delivery tube connected with flask A will show a greater rise in water level. When a burning paper is introduced in each of the flasks after removing the cork, the flame is immediately put off in flask A, but it continues for a short in flask B. Now, what does that prove? We know that oxygen supports combustion, right? Without oxygen, combustion is not possible. So, in flask A, we'll notice that already these germinating seeds have consumed the oxygen from this flask A, but in flask B, as the seeds are dead, so they haven't consumed the oxygen and it is stored inside that particular flask. So whenever we'll be finding that we bring or we bought a firing paper in front of flask B with the flames glowing high, we'll found that as oxygen is not present over there, the flame will immediately stops. Okay, it will immediately get stop. But in flask B, it will continue burning. Okay, this is one. Another one is, this proves that oxygen was absent in flask A, thereby showing that it was used up by the germinating seed, and the volume of oxygen so used up was indicated by the rise of water level in the delivery tube. There are two simple questions that would come in surely. Why there is a slight increase in the level of water in the delivery tube of flask B? Which of these two flasks, A and B, is controlled? So I have already told you that experimental and control setups, an experimental consists of two setup, an experimental setup and a control setup. Both are identical in which every condition is same except one. The setup in which the conditions under study is missing is called control. So here the setup A will be missing and here it will be present. Okay. So the next one is experiment to prove that carbon dioxide is produced during respiration in germinating state. So what we will be doing, we will be again taking one experimental setup and another one would be a control setup. What we will do is, we will keep soaked bean seeds, and another in flask B, that is control one, we will be keeping boiled bean seed. And for testing for CO2, we will be keeping lime water. So whenever we'll be keeping this particular thing for a time, and after that, whenever we'll be keeping that flask mouth in front of that lime water, we will see that lime water turns milky. This proves that carbon dioxide is present. Am I clear, my dear students? So carbon dioxide turns milky, lime water milky. Okay. Anyway, we have another alternative method. You can just go through that in figure 7.4. It is very easy. You can go through that and you will find what happens and how it is going on. The next one is experiment to prove that carbon dioxide is produced by green plants during respiration. ओके नाउ दिस प्रूव्स दैट कार्बन डाइऑक्साइड इज प्रोड्यूस्ड ड्यूरिंग रेस्पिरेशन आई विल बी डूइंग दैट इट इज वेरी इजी इन फ्लास्क ए एंड फ्लास्क बी विल बी कीपिंग टू फ्लास्क ओके इन वन लाइम वाटर्स विल बी क्लियर वट विल डू इज विल कीप सोडा लाइम वाटर इन फ्लास्क ए ओके नाउ यू प्लीज गो थ्रू द डायग्राम इट इज वेरी इजी टू अंडरस्टैंड थ्रू द डायग्राम ओके सो वॉट हैपन इन सोडा लाइम वाटर फ्लास्क ए लाइम वाटर इज क्लियर CO2 फ्री एयर इज गोइंग इन साइड ओके नाउ वी विल बी कीपिंग अ प्लांट व्हिच इज कवर्ड विद अ जार एंड द एयर दैट वी आर गिविंग इन साइड इज फ्री ऑफ कार्बन डाइऑक्साइड नाउ दिस प्रूव्स दैट दिस पर्टिकुलर थिंग डज नॉट शुड नॉट हैव एनी अमाउंट ऑफ कार्बन डाइऑक्साइड बट वी विल सी दैट दो वी आर प्रोवाइडिंग कार्बन डाइऑक्साइड लेस एयर टू द पर्टिकुलर प्लांट बट when we are taking out the water air from that particular plant we'll see that it is turning lime water milky this proves that this carbon dioxide is being produced by the plant otherwise it would not be possible to produce right and another one is experiment to show that heat is evolved during respiration now this is very easy what we'll do one we will be keeping germinating seed another one will be dead seed with antiseptic and we'll be putting thermometers over there And we will see that the experiment, the flask A, which is the experimental setup, will show a rise in temperature. But the B, which is control, it will not show a rise in temperature. Okay. Another one experiment to demonstrate anaerobic respiration. That this is very important. You need to go through it very carefully. Okay. What we will do is we will be keeping mercury because mercury cut off the air. Okay. So we will be keeping mercury. Now what happens? We will be keeping germinating seeds over there and mercury after 2-3 days we will see that the level of mercury from the test tube has slightly put down or went down. This proves that carbon dioxide is accumulated over in the top of the experimental setup. Okay. Peeling of the seed coats of the germinating seed before introduction, introducing them into the test tube may hasten the outer diffusion of CO2. Now, respiration is contrasted with photosynthesis. This difference is very important because respiration is the opposite of photosynthesis. That I have already shown you in my previous video lecture. What is this? Photosynthesis occurs only in the presence of chlorophyll. Respiration occurs in all the living cell. Photosynthesis occurs only in the presence of light. Respiration occurs at all the time. Photosynthesis uses carbon dioxide and water. Respiration uses oxygen and glucose. Photosynthesis, oxygen is released as an end product. Respiration, carbon dioxide is released as an end product. In photosynthesis, we have light energy is converted into chemical energy, which is stored. In respiration, we found that chemical energy is partially converted into heat and partially into useful energy for the various activities. In photosynthesis, result in a gain in weight. And in respiration result in loss in weight okay and then we found that food glucose is manufactured constructive or anabolic process but respiration is a catabolic process as we already have discussed about that result in loss of weight food glucose is broken down oxidized destructive or catabolic process respiration in plant compared with respiration in animal The basic aspects of respiration are same in all organisms. However, there are some differences in respiration between plants and animals. For example, in plants, there is no gaseous transport. The respiratory gases simply diffuses in and out the cell to cell diffusion. In animal, the blood transports respiratory gases. Right. Second point, one of the end product of anaerobic respiration in plant is ethanol or ethyl alcohol. But in case of animal, it is lactic acid. Okay. In plants, the process produces little heat as compared to animals. In animals, it produces a higher amount of heat. So, this completes the chapter of respiration in plants. And I hope this chapter is fully clear to you. For any of the questions, please do ask me. Or if you have any confusion or anything, please ask me. I'll be definitely here to help you out, to help with whatever I can. But please go through this video lecture to every of the lecture which I am sharing in the class so that it is useful and it is actually valuable for you all because it is a pandemic situation and we are having only online classes. So please go through the videos very minutely, very carefully. I am trying to explain as much as possible line by line, chapter by chapter, and with the help of diagrams and everything. You please go through this. We will be meeting in our next class discussing the problems, whatever problems we are having. And for any of the queries, please ask me. Up till then, take care of yourself, take care of your family, be safe, be healthy, and study hard. Thank you.